Threat modeling is a key component of any successful cybersecurity program. It allows you to identify and assess your organization's threats, what risks to prioritize, and what mitigation strategies will improve your security posture. To defend against threats targeted at you, you need a threat model. Let me demystify how you can go about creating one. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Adam, and I teach everything cyber threat intelligence. I've helped build TTI teams, refine processes, and train clients on the best practices. Today, I will pull back the curtain and reveal how you can build your cyber defenses to target threats relevant to your organization. I will walk you through several threat modeling methodologies and techniques, apply one of these to a real-life case study, and give you practical recommendations to get you started modeling your organization. But first, let's explore what actually is threat modeling and why it is so important. Threat modeling systematically identifies, evaluates, and prioritizes the risks that threaten your systems, applications, or overall security. You methodically analyze your assets and determine what vulnerabilities may exist, what attacks you are likely to face, and the potential impact if an asset is compromised. This allows you to mitigate and manage security threats effectively. As a cyber threat intelligence analyst, threat models will be the primary way of generating intelligence requirements for your organization. You will use them to structure the relationships between threats, like threat actors, behaviors, tools, exploits, and vulnerabilities, and what your organization cares about. This could be your important assets, vital business functions, and mission-critical data. Various threat modeling methodologies and techniques can be used to structure your threat modeling. That said, fundamentally, threat modeling is simply answering the question, what is important to my organization? What must be protected, and what is likely to be attacked. You then repeat this process over an extended period of time to proactively manage risk. Before jumping on how to perform threat modeling, let's first understand why it's so important. Threat modeling helps analysts answer three simple questions. What is important to my organization? What should I prioritize protecting? And what risks threaten these things? Answering these questions gives you a better understanding of what to focus on securing and how to do it. The answers to these questions will inform key decisions on your security strategy, what security investments to make, and how to improve your security posture and align it with your organization's needs. It is important to answer these questions even if you don't have a formal threat modeling methodology to generate the answers. These questions guide you from the mindset of doing security for security's sake and doing it to better protect key business requirements. This shift in perspective makes your security team, technologies, and processes effective in the real world. With this in mind, here are the key benefits threat modeling can provide you. It helps generate intelligence requirements. It allows you to identify knowledge gaps that need to be filled, critical assets that need protection, and threats that need to be mitigated. This knowledge helps you generate effective intelligence requirements. Threat modeling reduces risk. It allows you to identify and understand potential security risks threatening your systems, applications, or data, empowering you to implement mitigation strategies that reduce these risks. It also allows you to prioritize your resource allocation by highlighting resources you need to prioritize protecting and where to invest your security resources. Threat modeling also introduces security by design into your architecture. This minimizes vulnerabilities and the likelihood of critical vulnerabilities popping up. Threat modeling also improves situational awareness. It helps key stakeholders understand the security risks involved in a system or application so they can make informed decisions. Finally, threat modeling tailors your security to current threats. It is a proactive process that adapts to new and emerging threats to keep your systems, applications, and data secure as the threat landscape evolves. Threat modeling is a must-do activity for all organizations wanting to get serious about security. But how do you perform threat modeling? Let's explore. You can use various methodologies and techniques to perform threat modeling. A model just represents an idea, object, or system. The following methodologies and strategies help you build a picture of that model, including its components, importance, and associated risks or threats. Here are five popular threat modeling methodologies you can use. First up, we have STRIDE. It is a threat modeling methodology developed by Microsoft to help developers identify and categorize threats during the design and development phases of the software development lifecycle. It is represented by six categories based on its acronym. A software engineer will analyze the design of their software system using these six categories. Each category helps them identify potential vulnerabilities or missing security controls. As a security professional, you use crown jewel analysis to determine your organization's critical assets and then apply the six categories to assess the security posture of these threats. The second threat modeling methodology we'll look at is DREAD. It is a risk assessment methodology that evaluates the security of software systems or applications against five factors using a scale of 0 to 10. 0 indicates minimal risk or impact, while 10 indicates severe risk or impact. These five factors are based on the methodology's acronym as shown. Evaluating threats using these five factors allows organizations to prioritize their mitigation efforts and allocate resources to address the most critical security risks first. You can use DREAD to assess threats against key assets within your organization. If a threat actor compromises your organization's web server, how would it impact these five factors? Next up, we have Process for Attack Simulation and Threat Analysis, or PASTA. This is a risk-centric approach to identifying and evaluating security threats. It provides a structured framework for you to assess your security risks systematically. You first define business objectives. You need to understand what business goals a system aims to fulfill so you can align your security measures with the overall mission and its priorities. Next, you decompose the system into its main components. You break it down into things like functionalities, interfaces, data flows, and dependencies. Then you identify potential threats and attack vectors that could impact these components. Then you identify weaknesses or vulnerabilities within each system's components. Next, you model an attack scenario. Create a detailed attack scenario describing how an attacker could exploit the attack vectors, weaknesses, or vulnerabilities you identified to achieve their objectives. You then assess the likelihood and potential impact of the identified threats on your organization's objectives. Finally, you develop and implement strategies to address the identified security risks, like security controls, patches, awareness training, or redesigning the system architecture to minimize your risk exposure. Next up, we have attack trees. Attack tree threat modeling involves visualizing the various steps an adversary would take to achieve their goals and the impact this would have. You start at the root goal or node and branch into sub-goals and attack steps or leaf nodes. Visualizing attack scenarios is a great way to demonstrate threats to non-technical stakeholders. It also allows you to highlight points within an attack chain where security controls can be placed to prevent or disrupt an attacker. Finally, we have VAST, which stands for Visual, Agile, and Simple Threat Modeling. It is another threat modeling methodology focusing on identifying and mitigating threats during the software development lifecycle. However, it aims to streamline the process by emphasizing simplicity, agility, and visualization, making it accessible to a wider audience. Here is an overview of the key components of VAST. It uses visual aids like diagrams, flowcharts, and mind maps to represent the system architecture, potential threats, and mitigation strategies. It incorporates the principles of agile software development, like iterative development, collaboration, and flexibility, rather than conducting a single exhaustive threat modeling session up front. VAST also keeps it simple. It doesn't try to catalog every vulnerability and ensures that teams with varying levels of expertise can contribute to the threat modeling process. It fosters collaboration between stakeholders with diverse backgrounds and expertise, allowing you to see multiple perspectives so that relevant concerns are addressed and mitigation strategies are aligned with business objectives. Finally, the model integrates great into the software development lifecycle. It integrates threat modeling at the outset of any project and continues to threat model throughout the development process to ensure security is not treated as an afterthought and systems are secure by design. VAST is the more practical and flexible approach to threat modeling, making the process easier for a vast majority of organizations. That's enough theory. Let's look at how you would actually perform threat modeling in the real world using a case study. Let's step inside the shoes of a pizza delivery service. They have a website and a mobile application where customers can order pizza. They then deliver this pizza straight to their door. After performing a crown jewel analysis, you identify four key assets the pizza company must protect to continue its business operations. There's the customer data, the intellectual property, like the secret pizza recipe, the company's website for ordering, and the company's mobile application, again for ordering. Now you have these key assets, you can begin adding adversaries that would target them. You could add script kiddies or low-skilled attackers that may target the pizza website for fun. But more sophisticated threat actors may try to steal your customers' sensitive information for fraud. Next, you can overlay how an attacker would target these key assets, their tactics, techniques, and procedures, or TTPs. You can also include what they would go after and the impact on the organization. The DREAD methodology is a great one to model the impact of an attack on your assets. To model how an attacker may target your assets, you can pivot off of target information or adversary intelligence. Target information is information an attacker would go after. This could be customer data that includes financial information or PII. So add these two categories to your model. Adversaries. These are the tools, TTPs, or events an adversary may use or trigger when attacking your systems. You break events into reactive detections and proactive threat hunts and add them to your model. You can go as deep as you want into this layer, using attack trees to visualize the steps the attacker would take, or using PASTA to assess vulnerabilities that may arise in the software you use. Start at the top, add your key assets, and then work down to add granular details about subsystems, security controls, and software versions. Once complete, your threat model can fulfill various use cases. Threat modeling can be difficult if you haven't done it before. Using a structured approach and adopting one of the methodologies that I've previously discussed is beneficial. However, performing threat modeling in the real world can raise all sorts of unforeseen challenges. To help you out, here are some practical recommendations. Firstly, don't overtax yourself. Start with what your organization cares about and go from there. Next, never complete the threat model. Threat modeling should be an iterative process that evolves as threats and risks change. If your company is very large, build different threat models for separate business functions. You might have one for the HR department and another for the software developers. They will face different threats, so should have different threat models. Next, use intelligence to drive your threat modeling process. You need to gather intelligence on who will target your key assets, how they will do this, and how to defend against them. This will evolve over time as the threat landscape changes. Finally, remember threats are not always equally distributed. A threat for one organization may not be a high priority for another. You must tailor your threat model to match your organization's requirements and priorities. Threat modeling is the systematic process of identifying, evaluating, and prioritizing threats against your organization. It uncovers vulnerabilities you must patch, attack methods you must mitigate, and the potential impact of compromised assets. Take what you have learned here today, be it a threat modeling methodology or a practical recommendation, and get started with threat modeling today. Remember, start general and then gradually break it down into TTPs, vulnerabilities, specific systems, data repositories, and mitigation strategies that are tailored to your organization. Keep it simple, keep it continuous, and good luck. Also, stay tuned for more deep dives into key CTI topics and frameworks.